each of us in this room has gone to several teachers in our life. All of them have not made a difference in your life, have they? Some of them have. A few of them have profoundly transformed your life. While the rest have walked in and walked out like actors in a show. It wouldn't have mattered if you had replaced them with one or the other. True or not? So few people contributed to your life, the rest merely worked. So this is the challenge at hand. There is a profound difference, major difference in contributing and in working. It's a multidimensional problem. It has to do with our emphasis sometimes on process, sometimes it has to do with an emphasis on technology over human beings. Sometimes it has to do with institutional power as compared to the individual in front of you. Sometimes it boils down to plain callousness. Sometimes it comes to a situation where we just don't know that the other person's problem, what is the other person's real problem. We are simply blind to another human being's concern, issues or challenges. Now, how big is a problem in our society of this non-contributorship? Let me share with you a conversation I had with a CEO of a company recently. He's a CEO of a major insurance company. And this gentleman has 10,000 people working for him. And out of these 10,000 people, we're just having a conversation about salespeople, this, that, etc. And he says, you know, frankly, I don't think I have more than 500 real employees. So I said, what are the rest? Don't they get paid? He says, yes, they get paid, but they're not real employees because they come and then they go, they do something. They just somehow, many of them either pass time or even if they don't pass time, they just do the bare minimum so that I can't sack them. Only 500 of them run this whole company. If you went and talked to at least half a dozen CEOs, the average that will come to you will be in Indian corporations on 5 to 7% of employees are contributors. The balance are mere workers. When Swamiji said, I want workers, obviously he didn't mean these kinds of workers, right? He meant contributors. When he says work for the country, obviously he meant contribute and do something, make a difference to some people. When he says contribute, he says have human concern in every action in addition to technological or social or any other form of concern. That means combine all these into a whole so that you can serve the human beings who come to you. This is a rehumanization of society that Swamiji wanted us from us. Society has been steadily dehumanized, and I'm not saying something new. You know, very many good and high-level commentators have talked about the dehumanization of institutions, systems, technologies, etc. But we are also talking about a rehumanization of society at all levels. And that is, in a sense, the contribution revolution which Swamiji has set into motion. At the highest level, it is the worship of God in man. But at the simplest level, it is simply about being concerned about the human being in front of you and understanding human outcomes besides your process outcomes and besides your other outcomes that you normally anyway meet in your life.